Hello, and thanks in advance for spending about the next 7 minutes with me, Brian Emerson, president of Starlight Capital, Inc. If you, as an entrepreneur, wish to know more about our upcoming private equity conference in order to decide whether to participate, this is the right place. Here I will answer the 8 most frequently asked questions about the conference series. For more information or to register, please call me at area code 907-733-4303 or send me your company's executive summary to emersonb@starlightcapital.com. Question 1. A lot of conferences come and go. What is your track record? My business partner and I have co-hosted this event for 12 years. That's about 44 events, all at the same location in Midtown Manhattan, and all were sold out in advance. We accept no walk-ins to this invitation-only event. Attendees must meet certain requirements. 2. What is the day's schedule? Registration is 11 to noon, followed by a seated luncheon with open seating so you can sit with the color-coded financiers you wish to get to know. From 1 to 5, the first half hour encompasses several short company presentations, followed by a half hour of breakout sessions and networking. At 5:30, we host a gift drawing for all investors in the room, which helps retain them throughout the day for all presenters. From 5:30 to 7:30, the group enjoys a jazz cocktail reception for further networking. 3. Who attends? Who doesn't? This is an invitation-only event with an upper limit of 235 people, so an effective networker can meet everyone he or she wishes during the day. The attendees include about 12 to 15% companies, 8 to 12 non-presenting companies, usually earlier stage, and investors who have indicated to us that they are current investors looking for prospects. We do not invite the free drink crowd of service providers, although it is certainly possible that some of the investors have professional positions too. Question 4. Why do the presenting companies, non-presenting companies, and investors attend? What do they get out of it? In reverse order, the investors attend for an efficient introduction to potential deal flow. Many decline meeting requests from companies they don't know. Instead, they pay to attend our event in a convenient format for them. A validating percentage of our investor attendees repeat each year, or next time they want to sift through another batch of candidate companies. The presenting companies tend to fall into two different categories. One group has investment bankers and a roadshow budget to meet investors in different cities. They attend this conference as part of their East Coast tour. The other group of presenters does not have an investment banker to provide introductions to potential investors. This group may lack the Rolodex or staff or time to get many first meetings with financiers, but they want that exposure and are willing to do the presentation documents and follow up themselves rather than hire middlemen. Like the investors, these companies value the conference as an efficient time saver. They meet people who might not otherwise take their calls and have a warm introduction so they can follow up. The non-presenting companies tend to be earlier stage. Some want to network and collect business cards of financiers they can call in the future when their companies are more advanced. Others are learning from the presenters what to do, what not to do, while looking for early stage investors, board members, or advisors slash mentors from the audience. Question 5. How much do you charge? The price depends on the category of the attendee and how much exposure he or she wants. There are no back-end fees. The organizers expect no contingency payments if you are funded. Rather, this is a straightforward pay-to-attend and market-yourself model. The investors pay the least several hundred dollars. They pay because they regard our deal flow selection and presentation process a useful service to them. The non-presenting companies pay over $1,000, depending upon how many people they want to bring to work the room of attendees that might not otherwise schedule a meeting with them. The presenting companies pay several thousand, depending upon how much presentation time they want. Those who can deliver an efficient presentation in 5 minutes pay less than those who need, say, 10 minutes for a more complicated story. They value the exposure to the whole group, the professional communications help, and the beforehand and the resources to all attendees afterwards.
Number 6. Question. What behind-the-scenes support do presenting and non-presenting companies get before and after the event? Hi, I'm Laura, the pre-conference coach. All companies receive several documents in advance that outline helpful hints to make the most of their day, including funding financing tips, an executive summary template, access to a free communications coach, that's me, who's happy to help clients with their messaging on various documents, such as executive summaries, PowerPoint presentations, and their summary paragraph. At the event, each attendee receives a list of everyone else who's attending that's organized by both personal and company names. Everyone also receives a summary paragraph about each company and executive summaries of presenters printed in a book, and non-presenters can bring their own marketing documents. The following week, we send to each presenting and non-presenting company a list of additional names who have requested additional information about them. Finally, they benefit from a full-time, full-year staff that culls through applicants of both potential investors and potential entrepreneurs in order to ensure a relevant quality group for this invitation-only event.
Question 7. What is the likelihood of my getting funded through this event? The answer depends on a lot of factors. Some depend on the economy and your business sector. You probably already have some idea of the degree of investment interest in your industry segment, geography, business stage, because you've already contacted the likely prospects closest to you. A great deal depends on the experience of your management team to deliver what you hope to do with an investor's money. See some of our free articles on this subject at the starlightcapital.com website at the bottom. Some people do an excellent job of following up with everyone at the conference, taking notes, and then debriefing with management about the feedback and subsequent steps. Others are disappointed wallflowers who had expected a white knight to walk up to them with an immediate check and no due diligence questions, and their company didn't fare well after logical scrutiny. Specific to our 12 years of conferences, we don't always know if companies get funded because they do not have any obligation to report back to us. Many refuse to disclose their fundings for competitive reasons. However, every few years, we cull through the press releases and websites of past presenters. From their own websites, we ascertained over $300 million in funding for those who have attended. Others announced acquisitions and mergers with no price disclosure. Some others have folded or changed names. Question 8. How do I register? If you are a potential investor, talk with us first about your areas of current investment interest. If you are a potential presenter or non-presenting entrepreneur, please send us your executive summary or call us and register by phone or online. Thanks for having taken the time to hear this brief summary. You can reach me by email at emersonb@starlightcapital.com or call me at 907-733-4303.